Welcome back, everyone, to this amazing game. Alright, so back-to-back recording, so I'm still pretty grumpy because I'm tired. And this guy is still alive, which... Actually, you're gonna need to die here. So fast. So I guess we're gonna head right up there now. What's wrong with my audio here? I'm not speaking into the mic. There we go. This should be better. Because I was kind of like, my microphone is kind of like to the right a bit of my, screen. So I can't look at it directly whenever I'm looking at the screen. Right here. This is the river of blood. The item description I was talking about. What are they doing? What's that ninja? Ooh, oh, turn. Yeah. Wait, did that guy just have that little hum thing? So these guys have a connection to the dream. Crap. Delayed Molotov. This is the same room. This is the main area. Something. It's a bomb. Man, I'm... Oh, I feel so smart for figuring that out. The boom hammer. That was the coolest thing ever. Oh my gosh, man, that was sick. Man, I feel like a boss. Trick would have been used by the old hunters and crafted by the workshop heretics of powder kegs. Someone speculated that. They were right. No, that's cool. A giant hammer equipped with a miniature furnace, when ignited and fired, it emits a volley of flame that explodes if furious upon impact. Crush the beasts, then burn them. The brute simplicity of the boom hammer was favorited by hunters with an acute distaste for the beast. So, it buffs for one hit, and then, so what about, so the buff attack is like a little lunge, you can like multiple hit, no. Pretty sick. I'm gonna have to upgrade some of these weapons whenever I get back from my trip out west. I snowboard, for those of you who don't know. I know I talk about this a lot, so I'm not really gonna delve on it a lot, but yeah, that's like a big thing I do besides playing video games. So I'm taking a trip out west. It's pretty fun. It's gonna be pretty fun. Man, I still can't get over how scary that is, actually. There's a beast that's actually a beast. Man, you can see these chests and stuff. Man, there's so many moves on them. They really did a good job with the NPCs. He looks exactly like the dude. Firing hammer badge. So that guy was a powder keg. Very interesting. I wonder, do I have the beast claws on this? Yeah. Let's see. No, they didn't upgrade things directly. So there must be a new type of beast claw. Which I'm fine with, but it's interesting. Interesting. Yeah, that guy was really, really nicely designed. The floor just like creaked behind me. I just freaked the crap out. See, this difficulty would be such a so good in an actual horror game, but I don't think a game like this could be a horror game because you have such control over the character, which is a good thing. Like, I'm not critiquing the game. But a lot of people were playing this in search of a horror game, and they didn't get the experience, I feel like, because it's actually such a good game, it's not scary. Old Hunter top hat. Interesting. Oh, that's so cool. It's like a witch doctor thing. Let's stick with this. I know that completely doesn't make sense, but... Oh, these bloody leeches. Not leeches. Ticks. I hate these things with a passion. They're freaking deadly. I really need to speak into the microphone because you just didn't hear me say God. They have to be marking me. Something's counting down. Oh my god. What's up that way? Again. Man, you know what would be cool? Is if they threw that thing and it was like a time bomb. And if you like try to ram. Oh, that's the thing. On the ground, I got you down. If you ran and like got too far away from him, then it explodes. Or if you got too close to me. So these guys aren't that hard because they have parries. I thought I missed that weapon somewhere. Okay, so... There has to be one down here somewhere, though. Down. Like this way is where I should go. filthy, filthy turf. That. Yeah. Ridiculous. Still didn't find the lamp either. Guys, I'm one of you too. That's just gonna baller. Yeah, I went and upgraded it, put some gems in it. You're taking my health down slowly, but transformed attacks are just so slow. I don't know if it's hitting hard enough to deal with that slow of a wind up. I don't think it's gonna be powerful enough. I think it's underpowered. Alright, I'm gonna run into that. I want this Gatling gun, dude. Wonder if I can knock him over with Beast War. Man, I can't see him. I forgot to take my torch out. Man, there has to be a lamp somewhere, because I need to lure these guys out here. Oh, Oh wow, that actually exploded. Interesting. That's just like my word for this DLC. It's interesting. It's intriguing. I'm gonna start saying that. That's intriguing. Wow, this weapon is intriguing. Okay. Well, I found out that I am not a beast again. Yourself, do not try to run any straight line. It is the Prometheus school of running away from things. Alright. Said because of how loud that stuff is. This thing's reminding me of detonators off of Halo. Stop it. No. That turd just healed. Oh my gosh. Literally about to crap myself. Yes, 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 yes. Mother Francis, yes. Twenty-eight strength. Crap. This is highly customized portable version of stationary Gatling gun operated by the old hunter Jura and old Yarnum. It was the weapon of choice of the youngest of Jura's three companions. The Gatling gun boasts exceptional rapid-fire functionality, but is considered a cumbersome weapon due to its excessive weight and unsuitable consumption of quicksilver bullets. That is ridiculous. Man, did he kill all these beasts? I'm not surprised, that dude was a freaking beast. No, like... Oh, muffin. What to say? Other dudes don't hurt you. That's really smart of them to do that. Alright guys, well, getting the Gatling gun I think was a accomplishment for this episode. So once again, I will see you in the next one. Have a good one, guys.